is a request for Catania, Sylvia, and Rod. It was not a formal request, but those are the few people whose names I could find that said that they thought you could dedicate a whole video to just the recycled bags from Amazon. And you saw it on my rustic vintage journal video when I pulled out all of those supplies out of the Amazon bag. Paper. Let's just cut off this edge here because it's a bit rough. I have never bothered to neaten this up before because, like so many people, I tend to be in a hurry, so it's like, shove this in the closet. But I began saving the plastic bags there, and really like the sound of the crinkle, but this is far more rewarding to me because it's actually paper. See, it says recycle this mailer just like a box. See? It has a little code down there for you to contact them. And I imagine that if enough of us, you know, said something to Amazon, they might be influenced to use more paper and cardboard than plastic. I've tried to block off barcodes and anything that has identification of me or things I've bought or whatever. So they all have lines through them. And I used a blue do that. Look at this. This one got ripped so we can see what's actually inside of there. That is just a paper very thick, you can feel that that it is paper. Cushioned by those little white cotton. And it just makes the amazing crinkles. Can you see the little white spots through the paper? I can. It's just a slight shadow there, but you can see them through the thin paper. Such an interesting old paper. You could throw that in the fireplace and it would burn very nicely, but it's also very biodegradable. Got a little bit of that cotton or fluff stuff on my surface. Feel the sound of it. Look at all the tags on that one, my goodness. Lots of crossing out I had to do. Missed one. Yeah, I don't even know what they signify, those ones. Those little code bars are use your phone, you use it with your cell phone. Here's an edge that needs to be taken off to make it even. I will definitely reuse these bags. I don't know if the blue and white plastic Amazon bags are recyclable or not. But I'd like to be able to not be burdened with that packaging. That's the other thing, you know. The companies themselves, they need to take some responsibility for sending their product, you know. Because otherwise, then it puts the onus on the people to find something to do with the plastic that we're bringing home. And not all towns and not all places have solutions. So, poses a problem. And I think it's the companies that should take responsibility for their packaging. I don't know if any of you have seen what I've been seeing lately. Is a lot of advertising on Facebook lately. This is interesting. Look at this. It's a little strip of adhesive. Is that what that is? I wonder. Anyway, so, this one's a mess. This one's in really good shape. I don't even know why it survived the use that I've put it through. Because I have used this. This might be the one that I had for the video with the junk journal, but I can't remember for sure. Anyway, call it a junk journal because that's what I've discovered people are calling these old-fashioned looking homemade journals. Anyway, back to what I was saying. Yes, I've seen a lot of advertisements for well, here's an example. There is this laundry detergent you can get that comes in a sheet. It's just a sheet of soap, and you can just throw in a sheet of just soap. There is no packaging except for what these mini sheets come in. And oh my goodness, what a solution to those big friggin' plastic. There's a hole in this, look at there. See, I've got two of these now that I've saved that have these holes in it. Oh well, anyway. You know when you get a laundry detergent and they've got these big, giant plastic bottles. I feel so bad whenever I have to throw those away. It's just like, okay, that's a really great solution. Your soap does not have to be in these big freaking bottles of giant thick plastic. What are they thinking? And yet you feel like you don't have any choice, so I am going to buy that laundry detergent that you can buy in little thin sheets of dehydrated detergent. It makes so much sense. And now I've been seeing two of these. Oh, here's another bag I need to fix. Look at the strips. I'm gonna have to cut this way back because it's all messed up. Look at that. There's a big hole. This thing's coming apart, so I just want to trim that back, I think. Let's do that. Scissors. This plastic, not plastic, adhesive. That's really sticky. I don't even know how I got that off with it still remaining sticky like that. Yeah, let me get my scissors. That's not it. I don't know what that's for. Let's just take all that off and make it even at the front of the envelope here. There we go. I'll work on that. Anyway, what I was going to say is that they are finding a way to make toilet paper and paper products out of bamboo. If that is not the smartest, brightest idea, I don't know what is. Now, I'm not one of those people who's just a fanatic about conservation and all of that. Recycling and stuff. But I am a human being who has a certain amount of conscience about waste. Absolutely hate to see waste. So it just, it's logical. It's so logical to start using bamboo, which grows so fast, so easy to harvest, so easy to process. It's no more or less difficult. In fact, it might be less difficult than a paper mill, you know, cutting up whole trees or whatever they do to make paper. So, I'm all for that. I'm all for that. I just hope that it catches on to the point where it becomes a trend for most companies. You know, because we use so much paper and we use so much plastic. I'm not a plastic police. You will notice that there is a lot of plastic in my videos. But I definitely hate waste. If it isn't necessary, don't do it. But it's what it comes in. So I think the companies need to start taking a stand. And so, you know, I applaud Amazon for using these recyclable paper bags. And I love them. The sound is just as lovely as the plastic crinkles. Blah, blah, blah. Talk, talk, talk. So if you prefer no talking, there is a video. As most of you know, I do a no-talking version of most of my videos. I only talk in videos for the sake of the people who are triggered by voices, and I love it in ASMR. Oh, look at this one. This has a flap like they caught the end of another bag when they made this one. Because look, it looks like the part that folds over and seals. Isn't that interesting? See? Huh. Fascinating. And there's that strip. See? That usually goes on the flap, and oh, how interesting. Must have been at the end of a roll in the factory or something where they make these. Lovely, lovely. See, the bigger bags to have just a bit heavier paper so you can't see through. Like the other one, you can't see through and see those little cotton whereas the small ones, see the smaller bags, they to mail much lighter objects so they can use a lighter paper, right? And it's thinner paper, so you can actually see through it, and you can see those little white cotton dots. What do you call them? I'm totally losing the word. Insulation, filler, like bubbles are to bubble wrap, it's buffer. The smaller bags have a different tone in the crinkle. There we go. That's all of my smaller ones in a pile. I want to let you know now that this video is going to be doubled. I'm going to loop it. So you're going to hear this twice and see this twice. three medium-sized bags together. Or is this the largest? Let me bring those other ones over and look at them again. That's medium. Oh yeah, see, these are the largest ones. They're huge. I'm trying to remember what kind of things I got in them, but the bigger, heavier objects come in that. That's probably why they look a little worse for the wear, besides the fact that I reuse them. When they travel in the mail and they got something heavy in it, you know, you just grip the top of that bag, get it where it's going. Just put them in a neat pile here because I want to get them neatly put away. I am gonna put them away. Storage until I need them again. Okay, medium. Now, my smalls. There we go. Now, how should I store them? I've got four littles, 2, 3, and 4. Yep. Now I've got 3 middle sized, 1, 2, 3. Is this worth keeping? Yeah, because I can just put a piece of tape over that spot. And yes, the tape is made of plastic, but there's no other way of reinforcing that because I don't have a paper company. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna keep it and reuse that. I'll just put tape. All 4 bags. And I think they'll fit in a medium-sized bag. I think. Yeah, it's working. That'll do her. Alright. This can now fit in. There we go. Now, I can just take these medium-sized bags and fit that in to a leaf. Hey, hey, that works. Only one large left to fit. Can she do it? Can she do it? This one's a little messed up, I don't know. Oh, it's so flimsy, I can't make it work. Quiet, let me see. Recycle this mailer just like box. I could throw that whole package into a recycle bin wherever they take cardboard, and it would be just fine. Or just use it. Using something over again is a form of recycling. So that's my message to you today. Recycle or use it again. Thank you for joining me, guys, for this silly little Amazon bag video. Let's go around again, okay? Edge here because it's a bit rough. never bothered to neaten this up before, because like so many people, I tend to be in a hurry, so it's like shove this in the closet. But I began saving the plastic bags of theirs and really like the sound of the crinkle, but this is far more rewarding to me because it's actually paper. See, it says recycle this mailer just like a box. See? It has a little code down there for you to contact them. And I imagine that if enough of us, you know, said something to Amazon, they might be influenced to use more paper and cardboard than plastic. Block off barcodes and anything that has identification of me or things I bought or whatever. So they all have lines through them. And I used a blue pen to do that. Look at this. This one got ripped so we can see what's actually inside of there. That is just cottony paper. It's not very thick. You can feel that that it is paper, but it's cushioned by those little white cotton, and it just makes the amazing crinkles. Can you see the little white spots through the paper? I can. Light shadow there, but you can see them through the thin paper. Such an interesting concept. It's old paper. You could throw that in the fireplace and it would burn very nicely, but it's also very biodegradable. Got a little bit of that. Feel the sound of it. Look at all the tags on that one, my goodness. Lots of crossing out I had to do. Missed one. Yeah, I don't even know what they signify, those ones. Those little code bars are use your phone, use it with your cell phone. Here's an edge that needs to be taken off to make it even. I will definitely reuse these bags. I don't know if the blue and white plastic Amazon bags are recyclable or not. But I'd like to be able to not be burdened with that packaging. That's the other thing, you know. The companies themselves, they need to take some responsibility for sending their product, you know. Because otherwise, then it puts the onus on the people to find something to do with the plastic that we're bringing home. And not all towns and not all places have solutions. So, it poses a problem. And I think it's the companies that should take responsibility for their packaging. I don't know if any of you have seen what I've been seeing lately, but there is a lot of advertising on Facebook lately. This is interesting. Look at this. It's like this little strip of adhesive. Is that what that is? I wonder. Yeah, okay. Well, anyway, so now here's the, this one's a mess. This one's in really good shape. I don't even know why it survived the use that I've put it through. Because I have used this. This might be the one that I had for the video with the junk journal, but I can't remember for sure. Anyway, I call it a junk journal. And that's what I've discovered people are calling these old-fashioned looking homemade journals. Anyway, back to what I was saying. Yeah. I've seen a lot of advertisements for well, here's an example. There is this laundry detergent you can get that comes in a sheet. It's just a sheet of soap, and you can just throw in a sheet of just soap. There's no packaging except for what these mini sheets come in. And oh my goodness, what a solution to those big friggin' plastic. There's a hole in this, look at there. See, I've got two of these now that I've saved that have these holes in it. Oh well, anyway. You know when you get a laundry detergent and they've got these big giant plastic bottles. I feel so bad whenever I have to throw those away. It's just like, okay, that's a really great solution. Your soap does not have to be in these big freaking bottles of giant thick plastic. What are they thinking? And yet you feel like you don't have any choice, so I am going to buy that laundry detergent that you can buy in little thin sheets of dehydrated detergent. It makes so much sense. And now I've been seeing two of these. Oh, here's another bag I need to fix. Look at the strips. I'm gonna have to cut this way back because it's all messed up. Look at that. There's a big hole. This thing's coming apart, so I just want to trim that back, I think. Let's do that. Where's my scissors? Look at this plastic. Not plastic. The adhesive. That's really sticky. I don't even know how I got that off with it still remaining sticky like that. Yeah, let me get my scissors. That's not even sticky. I don't know what that's for. Let's just take all that off and make it even. At the front of the envelope here. There we go. I'll work on that. Anyway, what I was going to say is that they are finding a way to make toilet paper and paper products out of bamboo. If that is not the smartest, brightest idea, I don't know what is. Now, I'm not one of those people who's just a fanatic about conservation and all of that, the recycling and stuff, but I am a human being who has a certain amount of conscience about waste, and I absolutely hate to see waste. So, it's logical, it's so logical to start using bamboo, which grows so fast, so easy to harvest, so easy to process. It's no more or less difficult. In fact, it might be less difficult than a paper mill, you know, cutting up whole trees or whatever they do to make paper. So, I'm all for that. I just hope that it catches on to the point where it becomes a trend for most companies. You know, because we use so much paper and we use so much plastic. I'm not a plastic police. You will notice that there is a lot of plastic in my videos. But I definitely hate waste. If it isn't necessary, don't do it. But it's what it comes in. So I think the companies need to start taking a stand. And so, you know, I applaud Amazon for using these recyclable paper bags. And I love them. Sound is just as lovely as the plastic crinkles. Blah, blah, blah. Talk, talk, talk. So if you prefer no talking, there is a video. As most of you know, I do a no talking version of most of my videos. I only talk in videos for the sake of the people who are triggered by voices, and I love it in ASMR. Oh, look at this one. This has a flap like they caught the end of another bag when they made this one. Look, it looks like the part that folds over and seals. Isn't that interesting? See? Huh. Fascinating. And there's that strip. See? That usually goes on the flap. How interesting. Must have been at the end of a roll in the factory or something where they make these. Lovely. Lovely. See, the bigger bags appear to have just a bit heavier paper, so you can't see through like the other ones. You can't see through and see those little cotton whereas the small ones, see, the smaller bags, they expect to mail much lighter objects so they can use a lighter paper, right? It's thinner paper, so you can actually see through it, and you can see those little white cotton dots. What do you call them? I'm totally losing the word. Insulation? Filler? Like bubbles are to bubble wrap. Buffer. The smaller bags have a different tone in the crinkle. There we go. That's all of my paper bags. Now let's get them all together by size. Let's just put the smaller ones in a pile. I want to let you know now that this video is going to be doubled. I'm going to loop it, so you're going to hear this twice and see this twice. Now, let's put all the medium-sized bags together. Or is this the largest? Let me bring those other ones over and look at them again. I think that's medium. Oh yeah, see, these are the largest ones. They're huge. I'm trying to remember what kind of things I got in them, but then bigger, heavier objects. That's probably why they look a little worse for the wear, besides the fact that I reuse them, but when they travel in the mail, they got something heavy in it. You know, you just grip the top of that bag and get it where it's going. Just put them in a neat pile here because I want to get them neatly put away. I am going to put them away in storage until I need them again. Okay, medium. Now, my smalls. There we go. Now, how should I store them? I've got four littles, 2, 3, and 4. Yeah. Now, I've got 3 middle-sized 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's decide on this. Let's see. I'm gonna get them all in one somehow. I'm gonna figure this out. I think that's not too thick. Is this worth keeping? Yeah, because I can just put a piece of tape over that spot. And yes, the tape is made of plastic, but there's no other way of reinforcing that because I don't have a paper company. Okay, so yeah, I'm gonna keep it and reuse that. I'll just put tape. All 4 bags. And I think they'll fit in a medium-sized bag. I think. Yeah, it's working. That'll do her. Alright. This can now fit in. There we go, now. I can just take these medium-sized bags and slip that in there too, lovely. So 4 littles inside of the medium, all 3 medium, and a large. Now I have 2 large, so what should I do? Hey, hey, that works. Only 1 large left to fit. Can she do it? Can she do it? This one's a little messed up, I don't know. Oh, that's so flimsy, I can't make it. Love it. Love it. I love it. Those are my paper bags. Recycle this mailer just like box. I could throw that whole package into a recycle bin wherever they take cardboard. And it would be just fine. Or using something over again is a form of recycling. So that's my message to you today. Recycle or use it again. Thank you for joining me, guys, for this silly little